Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So as we know, before going to the vacation, we have started our lesson, that is components of food, or the components of the food, or the constituents of the food. So some points are still remaining from that lesson. So first we will continue with that same lesson, and today we will discuss the next point from the same lesson, that is minerals deficiency diseases. Okay. So minerals, there are the so many minerals that our body requires. Among that, there are the certain minerals which are very important to our body. And if our body will not get that minerals in enough quantity, then our body will suffer from diseases. And that diseases are called as mineral deficiency diseases. The diseases which are causes due to the lack of minerals in our body, the diseases are called as mineral deficiency diseases. So let's discuss about which are the mineral deficiency diseases. First, the mineral is iron. So if the body will not get the proper amount of iron, then the body will get suffer from the disease, and the name of the disease, that is anemia. So because of the lack of iron in our diet, the person will get suffer from the deficiency disease, that is anemia. And there are certain symptoms for the anemia. The symptoms for the anemia disease that are weakness and fatigue, loss of weight, pale skin, loss of appetite. Now weakness means what? You are not feeling fresh. Means whenever you are sleeping, every time you want to sleep only. That is weakness. You are not having enough energy to do certain types of the work. So that is weakness. Fatigue is also the same. Means you are not feeling every time fresh. Always you are feeling to sleep. You are not having enough energy, or you are not active. Your body is not active to the different types of the work. Next one is, there is a loss of weight decreases. Next one, pale skin, loss of appetite. Now appetite means what? Hungriness. You are not feeling hungry at all. Every time you are feeling the weakness, you are not feeling active or the fresh, you are not feeling hungry also. So these are the certain symptoms for the deficiency disease, that is anemia, which is causes due to the lack of iron. Next mineral we will discuss, that is iodine, which is very important, and the lack of the iodine causes disease, and the name of that disease, that is goiter. Okay. Next one, let's see the symptoms for the goiter. Abnormal enlargement of thyroid gland, retarded growth, mental disability. So as we know, goiter is causes due to the deficiency of mineral iodine. And this goiter is causes to this thyroid gland, which is present in our throat region. Okay. So what are the symptoms for that goiter? First one, it is abnormal enlargement of thyroid gland. So before, in our previous point, we have discussed about this thyroid gland, which is present in the neck region. Okay, which is present in the neck region. So if our body is lacking the iodine, then the growth of that thyroid gland get abnormal. Okay, there is not proper growth for the thyroid gland. It will get increase in the shape, or it will get increase in the size continuously, and it will causes the goiter. Next symptom for the goiter, that is retarded growth, mental disability. Now retarded growth means what? There is not proper, or there is not enough growth. There is not proper growth of your body. Physically your growth get stopped. Okay, that is retarded growth. Now because of the lack of the iodine, sometimes there is causes of the mental disabilities also. Okay, so these are the certain symptoms for the goiter, which is causes due to the deficiency of mineral iodine. Now the next mineral, that is calcium. So because of the lack of the calcium, the diseases causes that are bone and tooth decay. Okay, and which are the symptoms for the bone and the tooth decay? First one, weak bones, excessive bleeding of gums, stunted growth, tooth decay, and weakness. Okay, so because of the deficiency of the calcium minerals, the body gets suffer from the bone and the tooth decay. And what are the symptoms? How we come to know that body is getting suffer from the bone and the tooth decay? So some symptoms like weak bones, our bones get easily break because of the external force. Okay, sometimes the bleeding is coming from the gums. Stunted growth, here also the same stunted growth means what, the physical growth gets stopped. Next one is that tooth decay. The tooth is started to get decay. This point already we have seen in our previous lessons or in your previous classes. Next one is that weakness, and also we are getting suffer from the weakness. Now the last one mineral we will discuss, that is fluorine. And the deficiency of the fluorine causes the deficiency disease, that is dental caries. Okay, means because of the lack of the fluorine in the body, the person or that human body gets suffer from the dental caries. And what are the symptoms for that? Pain in the teeth, sensitivity to hot and cold food or drinks. Okay, so the symptoms for the dental caries are pain in teeth. These are the most frequently we can see in the dental caries. That is, there is a so much pain, there is a large pain happens in the teeth. And the next one is their sensitivity to hot and cold food or drinks. Now sensitivity means what? Because of this dental caries or because of the dental problem, the nerves of our teeth gets open. And whenever we are drinking some hot or cold, or whenever we are eating some food which is hot or cold, it will directly affect to that tooth nerves, and we are feeling so much pain. That is called as what? Sensitivity to hot and cold food or drinks. So these are the only few minerals we have discussed here, but there are so many other minerals which our body requires. But these are the certain minerals that our body requires in a more amount. Okay, so which minerals we have discussed today? Iron, deficiency disease for iron, that is anemia. Iodine, because of the lack of iodine causes goiter. Calcium, deficiency disease for calcium, that is bone and tooth decay. Fluorine causes deficiency disease, that is dental caries. So this is today we have discussed about the mineral deficiency diseases. Next point we will continue.